Hello everyone. For years at school, I knew as a fact that I had just memorised that the area of a circle is pi r squared, but I never really stopped to consider why. Today in this video, we're going to look at Archimedes' explanation for why that is. It comes from something called the measurement of the circle, which is really just a little collection of extracts, probably drawn from Archimedes' other works. So normally today, we say that the area of a circle is pi r squared, where r is the radius, but Archimedes didn't actually have that shorthand pi for talking about the ratio between a circle's circumference and its diameter. So he had to express this whole idea a little bit differently. And what he says is that the circle's area is equal to a triangle whose height is the radius and whose base is the circumference. And hopefully you can see that that area in modern terms is going to be a half times the base times the height, which is half times r times 2 pi r, so we get to pi r squared. And we're going to call this triangle's area t for triangle. Archimedes' proof is then a sort of classic Archimedes. We're going to sandwich the circle between an inscribed polygon and a circumscribed one and measure their areas and show that we can make each of them get as close as you like to t, both from below and from above. So we start with an inscribed square in the circle and a circumscribed square around it. And using the diagonal lines, I've split each of them into four triangular quadrants. These triangles, the four bits, they all have the same height, the distance from the center of the circle to each side. So their total area is half of that height times the sum of the bases. In other words, times the perimeter of each square. So for the inner quadrants, what we've got is the height being less than the radius and the perimeter being less than the circumference of the circle, because the fastest route around these four points is to take the straight lines between them. So overall, the area of that square must be less than t. In the outer square, the height of each quadrant, well, this time it's equal to the radius, but the perimeter this time is greater than the circumference. So the area is going to be more than t. Next, what we do is double the number of sides. So this creates two octagons, which are in blue. And just like before, their areas can be thought of as eight congruent triangles. So we can calculate the total area using the formula half of the height, which is the same in each, times the perimeter. So again, the inner octagon, the eight triangles between the blue and black diameters, have area less than t, while the outer octagon, the eight triangles between the green diameters, is going to be more than t. And there's nothing special in what we've done so far about squares or octagons. In fact, any regular polygon inscribed in the circle is going to be composed of congruent triangles in this way. And their height is going to be less than the radius, and their perimeter is going to be less than the circumference, and so on. Same on the outside. But importantly, the two octagons have both got closer to the area of the circle than the squares did. And in particular, they're getting exponentially closer. So Archimedes doesn't discuss this fully, but we can bring in an argument that he used in his other work, The Quadrature of the Parabola. Each of the segments outside the inner square, when we move to octagons, it gets a triangle in it. And that triangle is half of the area of a rectangle formed by the base of the triangle and a little bit of tangent opposite it. And that rectangle is clearly bigger than the segment of the circle. So in other words, if the triangle is half the rectangle, it's more than half of the segment. And on the outside, we'll talk about sort of the leftover bits that the circle doesn't fill up in the corners of the circumscribed polygons. So if we look at A and B, this is a right angle because tangents make right angles to the radius. So that means that AB is a hypotenuse, and so it's going to be more than MB. MB is the same as BC because the tangents from B to the circle have to be both the same length. So triangle AMB is going to be more than half of triangle AMC, and that is more than half of this leftover area between the outer square and the circle. So again, we see that the outer leftovers decrease by a factor of more than 2 each time, so faster than the series 1, 1/2, 1/4, 1/8, and so on. Now, at this point, we might sort of jump ahead to talk about limits as the number of sides in each polygon sort of zooms off towards infinity. But Archimedes always wanted his proofs to take a finite number of kind of achievable steps. So he does the following. Suppose first that the circle's area is any proper amount x bigger than t. Remember, that's the area of that target triangle. And by a proper amount, I'm referring to Archimedes' assumption that areas are never infinitesimally small. In other words, if you get enough copies of x, you're going to be able to add them up to make as big an area as you like. Now, if we bisect the quadrants of the inscribed square enough times, what we're going to get, as we just showed, is an inscribed polygon that is close enough to the circle that its area is more than t. The difference between the circle and the inscribed polygon is going to get less than x at some point. But we saw that any polygon inside the circle can be broken down into triangles where we can see that the total area is going to be less than t, so we get a contradiction. And we can do exactly the same thing on the outside. If the circle's area were less than t, we can bisect the quadrants each time repeatedly until you get a circumscribed polygon where the leftovers, the bits around the outside, outside the circle, are less than x, and so we get that that circumscribed polygon also has an area less than t. But, as we saw before, it's composed of triangles whose height is the radius and whose total base, the perimeter, is more than the circumference, so the area should be more than t. And therefore, we've got a contradiction both when the circle is any amount bigger than t and when it's any amount smaller. And so we can infer that they are equal. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this method of showing that the circle's area is as close as you like to this set of congruent triangles whose height is the radius and whose total base is the circumference of the circle. So we end up finding out that the area of a circle is pi times the radius squared. If you enjoyed this, do be sure to check out my other videos on Archimedes, because he used these techniques a lot in his works. Thank you very much for watching.